This world is full of unsolved mysteries. From criminal cold cases to ancient civilizations lost to time, people are constantly searching for new ways to find the answer to some of life's greatest unknowns. I've already covered a number of mysteries on my channel and tried to answer them myself using what information I can gather, though it can be quite frustrating when attempts to find a conclusion leads to a dead end. So here then are three mysteries that, after years of being unexplained, have finally been solved. In Death Valley National Park, California, there is a dry lake which goes by the name Racetrack Playa, and is home to an unusual geographical phenomena which stumped scientists for almost a century. Since 1915, various rocks ranging from a few hundred grams to hundreds of kilograms had been observed showing visible trail lines behind them on the dry surface, with no sign of human or animal intervention. It seemed as though hundreds of stone slabs had moved across the desert ground without reason, some as far as 200 meters, leaving experts baffled at how this was possible in the absence of an external force. Direct observation of the rocks moving wasn't witnessed during the early investigation, and so the evidence of the trail marks were all that scientists could use to try and determine what was causing their movements. Experts noticed that the path the stones took were completely irrational and differed in both direction and length. Some rocks would travel parallel to each other for a short time before abruptly changing course, even back in the direction they originally came from, whilst others would even turn over during their journey and continue along the ground, leaving a different track in its wake. Various theories and explanations were put forward over the years, ranging from highly complex weather patterns to supernatural interference. The most favoured hypothesis at the time was that strong winds, including dust devils, played a part in the rock's movement whilst the ground was wet, but with some stones weighing as much as an average human, it was difficult to justify how they could travel so far under these conditions. It was finally in 2013 that, using time-lapse photography and GPS technology, experts were able to observe the phenomena take place for the first time. After years of speculation and debate, a research team witnessed and documented the movement of over 60 rocks between December 2013 and January 2014, finally solving the mystery of the saline stones. They observed that large ice sheets began to form across the barren dry lake bed during the cold winter nights. As the sun would rise the next morning, ice would begin to break apart and slowly melt, causing the rocks which sat amongst them to drift along with it across the ground, with further encouragement from light winds. Rocks were observed moving up to 5 meters per minute, with some moving for up to 16 minutes at a time, finally putting a 100-year-old mystery to bed. On the 20th of August 2007, a young girl was walking along the coast of Jedediah Island in British Columbia when she spotted a shoe that had washed up on shore. When she inspected further, upon opening the sock contained inside, she found a human severed right foot decomposing within the Adidas trainer. 6 days later, on Gabriola Island, not far from where the first foot was discovered, a couple found a Reebok trainer on the shoreline which contained another decaying right foot. Since then, a further 19 feet have been discovered inside various footwear between 2008 and 2019. Some feet belonging to the same person, but found months apart from each other and in different locations. All of these discoveries have been on the coastline of the Salish Sea, a network of channels and waterways which stretch from British Columbia to Washington, and all share strange similarities. Every foot was found inside footwear and had been disarticulated from the rest of the body due to sea decay. Finding a foot in such a condition was considered by one police officer to be a 1 in a million chance, so finding 21 over the course of 12 years is peculiar to say the least. Many local residents feared the possibility of an active serial killer in the area, whilst others believed that the limbs could have belonged to victims of a plane crash or natural disaster. There were also cases of hoax feet found in some circumstances, with pranksters leaving skeletonized animal paws and raw meat inside shoes to be found by the shoreline. It would take a decade before anything conclusive would be said on the mystery, and Barb McClintock of the British Columbia Coroner Service was able to provide some answers in December 2017. McClintock was able to determine the identities of 8 of the feet, with some being matching pairs belonging to 6 different people. No foul play was suspected in the deaths of these individuals, with some being identified as previously dealing with severe depression or knowingly attempting suicide, whilst others could have been the result of accidental death. The manner in which these feet detach from the rest of the body are consistent with the decomposition process, with the remains showing no sign of trauma, such as being severed purposely by an animal or blade. Water submersion also speeds up the process of decay, whilst the shoes act as a protective buoyant casket to keep the foot intact until it eventually finds its way to shore. Lastly, with winds predominantly travelling from west to east, the chances of anything floating in the Pacific Ocean is almost inevitably going to make its way to the Canadian and American shorelines, although it is surprising just how many feet have ended up in the same location. With feet still being found on the shoreline as recently as January 2019, it's likely that this strange phenomena will continue to occur for years to come, and more victims of ocean tragedies will eventually be discovered in the Salish Sea. The year is 1997, and William Moldt, a 40-year-old mortgage broker, is in a nightclub in Lantana, Florida. He phones his girlfriend at around 9:30 p.m, informing her that he will be leaving soon, and eventually does at around 11 p.m, driving home alone in his 1994 white Saturn SL. Unfortunately, William never reaches his destination, and is sadly never seen again. Witnesses state that Moldt was a quiet man who kept to himself, rarely drank, and didn't seem intoxicated before leaving the club that late November evening. Nothing on the surface seemed to indicate any reason for Moldt to go missing, and despite launching an investigation into his disappearance, police couldn't determine his whereabouts, and the case went cold. For 22 years, Moldt's disappearance remained a mystery, and those who knew him would forever wonder what happened that fateful night. Then one day, in 2019, more than 2 decades later, an unlikely discovery finally solved the mystery. Jerry Nyman, who works in the transportation department for the Palm Beach County School District, used Google Maps frequently to track school bus routes in the Florida area. When discovering that his ex-partner's 2 daughters went to a school that he managed, he decided to open up Google Maps and check their route from school to home. Whilst moving through the map, he noticed an unusual object which looked like a submerged car in one of the man-made lakes, and messaged his ex-girlfriend, who lived nearby, to go and take a look. At ground level, the murky green water made it impossible to see anything beneath, so neighbours used a drone and confirmed what Jerry saw: a car submerged below in the artificial pond. Divers and salvage teams managed to pull the car from the lake, and inside the rusting 1994 white Saturn were the skeletal remains of William Moldt, the man who had been missing for over 22 years. After an investigation, authorities presumed that Moldt had lost control of his vehicle and driven into the pond after leaving the nightclub in 1997. However, with the area being under development at the time, looking more like a building site than a thriving community, his fateful accident went unnoticed, and the dark waters would hide him from view for over 2 decades. Thanks to the evolution of satellite technology and sheer luck on Jerry Nyman's part, the mystery of William Moldt could finally be laid to rest.